Hello, hello. This is Art Craft Time with Cara. This is your canvas, this is your channel, and I'm your artist, Cara Aisling. Today is all about hair and air. That's right, we got hair and air today. And we have a painting. It's the Tree of Love. This is February. I'm feeling the month of love is shaking up here. So what we have here, I've printed out like four different types of paintings here. Now, some of these are photographs, some of these are played with, some of these are someone's paintings or digital art. And I love a little bit of everything from every single one of them. Now, what I'd like to do is take this one. I adore the blues transitioning to the yellows, and I see the reds. There's a touch of orange right here into the reds. So I'm going to use this one for the background. This one's just beautiful. I like to use this one because I love how the artist was able to like really put up the roundness of the tree. Like, it really has a good quirky about it. And I don't think we're going to do a whole bunch of leaves on the ground. So I was thinking like this one will do some grass that's following along. It'll be really nice. And going back to this one here, you will see some leaves that are blowing here and there. I'm going to turn those into the little hearts, little heart-shaped leaves that are coming off. Now, because there's a lot of light source coming around from this one right here to transition what I want, I also really like this one. I like how the light comes from behind them. So I'm going to use that to really punch out the lighter skies of the clouds. And the clouds around that one there. And I think that'll look super cool. So taking about four different pieces and combining them into one is things that you can do as well. We're not copying these people's art. We're gonna make it our own. I mean, draw a tree with has a heart shape. You can Google it and there's just thousands of images. So it's not like they're the only ones that have come up with this, so we can use this. But one thing is to do it is to take sky from one idea, like the leaves turn them into heart shape, you know, the poofiness, the colors of one, the grass from another, the light source from another. That's how we're gonna rock this. So the Tree of Love. All right, so the paint colors we have today is white, black, yellow, canary yellow, a gold like a lion yellow, and we have fire engine red and a royal blue. Now I've taken the royal blue, thinned it out, and I've also made a baby blue with adding some white and thin and some paint thinner, some airbrush thinner here. And I've also have this one thinned out and ready to rock and thinned out. Now I've made three different hues to work with, kind of a light, medium, and darker that we're going to be using. And my black is also thinned out. That one is probably close to almost a 50-50 percent here using airbrush thinner and ratio. Now my thinned out white here that I have is about a 4-to-1. And so our paintbrushes we're going to be using here today, there's a few here. I haven't decided on which fan brushes, so I've grabbed three different fan brushes. And I have some chisels for our backgrounds. And I have one round that we're going to be using, and then some liners here. And also, this is my script. I have two script and one liners. And those we're going to be using for the tree. And for acrylic paints, we'll be using Mars Black, Burnt Umber, Dioxine Purple, Azurian Crimson, it's like a burgundy, and a royal purple, Cadmium Red Medium Hue, and a Titanium White. Okay, so our next step is we're going to do the background first. We're going to do with the blue fading in with the yellow and the white and the red. I also need you to bear with me. I started setting up about an hour and a half ago to make this video happen, and it actually only took me 5 minutes to set up what I wanted and a bunch of other stuff to get things going, to get all my paperwork out and everything. And I'm a little tired now and it's late, so I might not be as talkative. I really want to paint still, but I'm a little tired. So I might do this in a couple parts. Tomorrow morning I'll do some more painting, I'm sure of it. So for now, if I'm not as talkative, or if I'm not going to do a time lapse, if you can just see how I'm just going to rock the background. I may or may not continue. And we'll see what happens from there. Anyway, if not, you won't notice that I'm just going to do this. I'll hit this up in the morning and we'll continue in this video. We're still, for you, a time lapse has not even happened. I mean, starting off with baby blue. Already ready to go, already thinned out. I have an inexpensive canvas, so what I did, I had to actually bomb it with some white first, because it doesn't have any primer or anything on it. It's a Tebow. So I just, before I started the video, I bombed it with some white, so there's probably just a little bit caught up here on my end of my tip. So now we're just going to just blend it up just a little bit more. This tray's a little bit lighter and has a nice transition from the alcohol, from a little darker into the lighter. And then more of a lighter spot here in the clouds coming in. So I'm just going to bring in some lighter bits. I'm going to kind of make some guidelines where I'm going to rock in my clouds there. Now I like to bring across here. We're going to go into some reds. Just going to do a quick little extra bomb along the bottom. just to have a really bright white underneath that for the red. Okay, just grabbing the red. Now I'm just going to lay a bit of airbrush of red down, but I might either just leave that as is, or we're going to paint in some grass too. We'll just see what's going to happen there. So we're just going to lay in just the layers first. So first it's going to look a little pinkish. Going to make some clouds. It's going to be that easy. I have this, the ratio on this for my white is 4:1. I have it quite diluted. Thank you. that was close. All right. There's a reason why you're supposed to have a cap on this. First, I wanted to work on building up the clouds, and then I'm going to do a little bit of a liner on them. So keep building up there. So if you notice, I'm kind of going back and forth, because while one starts to dry and evaporate, then I come back in and I can see where I need to build it. Just do soft layers and flow it in there. Take your time. I really don't blast it in hard and fast first. Just go in with nice soft layers. Casting a shadow. I want to make these clouds down here darker. Okay, really hit it with some white because we're going to lay some oranges or some yellows over top of that. Now I think I'm not going to put the tree in the center because I really love how the clouds look here. Something kind of off-centered right here. So I better quickly draw on the shape of the heart because I want to do some light coming out from behind it. So needing that, we're going to need a quick little reference here. So just with like a medium yellow coming in behind here. There might be a little white still left off, so I'm just gonna let that spray out. There we go. Now I want this to overlap a touch from where the gold's gonna be. Okay, now taking in our darkest, like a lion yellow, ochre yellow, and we're just gonna go over to I'm gonna stop myself right there. I mixed up this yellow. It was supposed to be a lion yellow, and this brand does not mix as politely, let's say, as the acrylic. So I'm gonna stop so I don't mess it up. I gotta figure it out. I'm gonna go back to the yellow. I'm gonna go back to the yellow and just bring in that. I'm really not liking how bright that is. Yeah, I can bring it. There we go. So I'm just gonna bring in there. This was just mixed in some like sunflower yellow mixed in with that medium hue of that. I'm just going to go over top of some of these clouds. Okay, I create a quick hue there. I'm going to go back with my white and just add the clouds in a different way than I had planned here, but it'll work out pretty cool. There we go, I can tone him out that way. They were the tone down that yellow, but still have the depth in that I wanted with the clouds and not lose that. Well, that was a bit of a burst. Sometimes we get a bit of a pop, not a disability. Okay, remember where we have our gentle outline for our tree. We just wanted to have, before my camera runs out here, just gonna put in now just want the light coming behind it a little bit more. I think I just love how that is in that picture. Thank you. For our next part, we're going to be bringing in some acrylic, some titanium white, and some yellow ochre. No, it's just a titanium white. You just have a dry brush. And what is this one here? Number 7, round boar's hair. Want to keep it super, super, super dry. And we're going to be just going in like little light circles here and just going, just kind of highlighting over. I want to keep the line up here softer, so I'm going to be bringing in more of the color down into here, more of the titanium white over top of the airbrush. Okay, now heading into burnt umber with some highlights of some yellow ochre. Just a little dot. Oh, too much. There we go. Load it up, twist it out. Okay, so my tree outline is right here. And I'm gonna bring down the stem about to, right about to there. Just at the base, just bring it out just a touch thicker. Curl it out a little bit. We're going to do some leaves at the bottom, so not too worried about what that entails here. It doesn't have to be perfectly straight. I'm going to throw just a little knot here. Dipping into the highlight just a little bit on the sides now. Just gonna be this because my sunlight's coming from here and working out that way. So I'm gonna have some highlight around that knot. I'm going to bring up the tree in here. I want to bring some nice branches coming in. Let's see here. Keeping in my shape too. This is where the scripter comes in really nice, and just keep your hand out. Well, this is all dry. This dries incredibly quick. That's why I like acrylic and like the airbrush. Because I can get faster results because I'm too impatient to wait for oils. This is nice and easy, nice and quick. Okay, next we have our leaves. So we're going to take just the tip and just the tip and just, we're just touching. It's going to be taking a bit here to do, and we're just touching. We're going to start here where we're going to see some of the lighter leaves come through. So doing behind here first. If you get any over the trunk where you don't want any in the front, you can always just touch that up. Just ever so lightly, and just definitely take your time. Now I like to keep this exposed. I want to see a lot of these lines here, a lot of the branches, sorry. So I want to see those. I'm just going to fill that in here around it. You do want to see the sky and the blues and the oranges and the greens and yellows peeking through there. Just going to make a slight line around the edge just so you can see where I'm going to. There, now you can see what I'm doing. Forget to leave light poking through. Now I'm pushing up when I go in and up at the same time. Okay, now bringing in my bores, going to be stamping in, going in with some darker, so I'm going into with some burgundies now. So I'm going to make it a little darker in here so I can puff out and maybe round out the bits in here. And I'm just going now in between my blues, the red, so overlapping the blues just ever so slightly, not too much. I don't want to lose all that blue that's peeking through there, and I really like that. Going back to my red, I'm just building up some more layers. Going back to the burgundy now, I'm going to go in with just a little bit of brown. Some burnt sienna, burnt umber, sorry. You don't want to use black, it'll take over too much. And you can notice I didn't rinse out my brush either. So red, punch in some brown, still mixture of the two colors on here. Definitely did not clean out the brush. You want to have it so the colors will mix on the brush together when you're doing this. So red, stamp, stamp, with the brown. Going in with just red, going that burgundy, and I really like pulling it out. I like texture on my painting. It's a wonder I never got into oils, hey? But I definitely love that texture you can bring out with the acrylics. Going in with red now. Still keeping mindful, I want some of that blue coming through. Mm-hmm. Thank you.
Okay. So I'd like to add a little bit more branches back in there now. Just going back in this with the brown, just some thin little guys. And go to a finer. I just have some red mixed in with the brown there. And I want some super, just 1 second here. I think I need thinner. One more moment. Just bring in a few little branches here. Just draw some out. Just going to bring back one of those branches right here. And I left some branches poking out on purpose so I can do this at the end and just pull some down into it. And then just go through and just pull a little bit of branches here and there. Just let that dry a little bit more up top, and then I can rock in some more branches. Okay, let's go down to the bottom here. In the bottom, back pretty smooth here. I like to drop some leaves in the bottom here. There we go. Now we'll rock into some grass. Just pulling it down. Pull you out for a good look here. Now I'll put in some little leaves here. Hear my dog snoring pretty good right about now. Holy. Now taking a really, really, really tiny fine brush, we're going to do just a really neat stem here. Very, very, very fine. And then a little dot at the end. Every single time you go to do a line, grab another bit of paint. Now we'll put in some little leaves here. Hear my dog snoring pretty good right about now. Holy. Heart-shaped leaves, yeah. Dog. Violet! Violet, you're having a dream. Pick up, puppies.
Well, we're done already. I didn't even think it was going to take this long, to be honest. I actually stopped the camera when I was done and just kind of stared at it for a bit and was trying to find something else to do. But it's done. I love it the way it is. I love bringing in the airbrushing with the dry brushing with the paintbrush as well. Lots of dry brushing, a lot of stamp brushing. We didn't really do any blending at all. We let the airbrushing and the background do that, from the blues to the greens to the oranges to the reds rocking in. It was fun. I love the little love tree. I hope you did too. It was wonderful hanging out with you today. Throw me down a little comment. What part's your favorite part? If you have any suggestions for future paintings, I'd love to see that too. Well, thanks for hanging out with me today, and throw me down a like, sub, and subscribe, and help support the free content channel. Have a good one.